We might actually get
a big one. Okay.
Since you took a million scopes of me when I wasn't expecting you, I'll be even with him and take all of them. They're saying hi, Ken.
Okay, I'm in DI number 22.
I apologize. The two vocals, 7 and 8 that you're, you need two vocals?
Yes.
Perfect. What's up with you? You're on the next floor, you're on vocal 7 and 8. I've got bass 2, I've got fill, and I'm not sure where your guitar is yet.
I have 2 inputs for my fiddle, and so I have the one microphone that I don't think is quite on yet. And I can tell you what channel it is.
Okay.
That's channel 15, which needs scale and power. And that's my
15.
Yep.
That's
so, yeah. 14 is DI, and 15 is the microphone.
Yeah.
Do you have a preference on sound, DI versus microphone?
Yeah, DI the monitor and microphone. And if you need a way to listen to that,
it's also good. Okay, okay. Yeah, so you know what your levels are?
Yeah.
Guitar at front of house. I mean, I can hear the stage well. I'm just not listening to the mic out of it. Okay. And bass, we should have parked you on the other side of the room, but I like it. I hope you hear some drooling bass play. I actually asked Matt last year how we had you tuned into the rig in the dance track, because it sounded great, and he said, I don't at all, it's just the bass rig, so.
We're waiting on our percussionist. He should be here in momentarily.
Copy that.
Can I test my...
Yes, let's go with your guitar.
I'm going to check it out.
Do you have number 22? That's my guitar. Coming out from the ledge. Would you like more guitar?
I'm not hearing anything.
I'm not hearing anything.
There you go. Yeah. Right here.
Okay.
That's good. That's fine.
Oh, cool.
Attention everybody, is there anyone that doesn't have a line yet?
Keep going.
Thank you. Lives of Woody Guthrie and Pete Seeger, the godfathers of this festival, and we're going to start the afternoon off. One thing that I wanted to say is everybody on stage is going to be playing along with everybody else when at all possible and singing along with everybody else. I think Woody and Pete would have wanted it that way.
Can I add something to that?
Yeah, and Woody you all are supposed to sing
you.
Along with us as well. They would be rolling over in their graves if you did not. So please sing if you know any of the words. And we're going to start the afternoon off with Michael Bromfeld singing Woody Guthrie's Philadelphia Lawyer.
Hey, everybody. I first learned this song as Reno Blues, but I guess more of you do know it by its title, Philadelphia Lawyer. I can almost guarantee that none of you out there have ever actually heard it performed live by a real-life, genuine Philadelphia lawyer. And that's going to change now. We out. Reno, Nevada, where old man's blooms and fades. A great Philadelphia lawyer would love if Hollywood man. Come love, we will go rambling. Now where the lights are so bright, I'll your husband, and we can get married tonight. While Bill was young, so cowboy, 10 notches carved.
To go next, but our song sounds almost exactly like that song. So in the
I think it's true of the next five songs. I'm the daughter of a lawyer, so I have loved a lawyer my whole life. But honestly, like in this era, I have never felt so grateful for the work of lawyers.
And sad to say, this song is as true today as it was when Woody wrote it in the 1930s. This is a song called Deportee.
Yes.
Raps are rolling and the peaches are rotten. Oranges are piled in the neck. So dumb, flying you back to the Mexican border to pay all your money. Late that day, goodbye, goodbye. My one, goodbye, Rosalita. Adios.
You low life trifling bastard, you ignorant son of a bitch, you goddamn grocery stealing scab, you toadstool for the rich, you yaller back piss complected scum. You low-polluted, power-mad drunk. You're what I call a no-good, dirty rat. Well, what do you think about that? You little odious vermin. You prophet-worshipping dog. You mother-killing, baby-starving pimp. You swine, you filthy hog. You obscene worshiper of greed. You strangling, worm-infested weed. You obnoxious scumbag of pus. No way, that ain't enough. Cause you're a little boot-licking stoolie. You're a low-down snake in the grass. You cowardly maggot of slime. You thieving horse's ass. You puke-faced rabbit mangy hound, you better off lost than found. You two-faced petrified turd, take heed while I give you the bird. Who are you? Where are you? You vile, haywired organizer of death and destruction. You stool pigeon for the greedy side. You bodyguard for the big shot lord. You worshiper of greed and wealth and all that's bad, you know who you are. As I go walking that freedom highway, nobody living ever stop me. Nobody living can ever make me turn back. Cause this land was made for you and me.
Thank you. I've got buckets full of new cussings. Gaslight Tinkers are up. They're gonna do You Ain't Got No Money.
I have no idea who that song was about.
Why weren't you guys singing along?
This song, actually, so a lot of you might know that I Ain't Got No Home had a parody written by Woody of his own song, dedicated to Donald Trump's father, when he was Woody's landlord. I'm not gonna sing that. We're not gonna sing that. But look it up if you don't know it. I'm sure half of you actually know it.
They're going to sing the song for us instead.
But there's a little added verse in here we wrote 4 years ago or so.
Oh, really?
We did, yeah. There's actually a verse that's not Woody's. You didn't know that, Jared? Yeah. Born Below the Border. That's
Peter, that one. All right.
We don't know each other very well. We just met 4 years ago. It's been 10 years. Anyway, I'm sorry. Let's play the song. Sing along, please.
Just a wandering murderer, I go from town to town.
the Rio Grande. I'm here to raise my son. My boy ain't got no homeland, but raise American. Ain't got no home in this world.
Participatory. Are you ready? You're a beautiful sight. It's so lovely to be back here on this farm with all of you lovely people. If you've never been here before, welcome. May you find home here. This is Annie Wins. She's gonna lead us.
But I need you to sing along. So how many of you can go? Hey up, ho, away my well, away my well, away my well. Hey up, ho, away my well.
Harmonies, away my well, with harmonies.
Away my well now.
Away my well.
Thank you. Thank you, thank you. So that was our celebration of Woody. Thank you, Woody. Thank you for all that you have given us and continue to give us. There are archives and archives and archives that we can delve into and find more of his genius. Now we are heading into the Pete part of the night. And recently I parked behind a car that had a quotation that they attributed to Pete Seeger that I'd never heard before. And it began, "There might be no hope." And it ended, "But I might be wrong." And I kind of loved that, because it was one of those days where I thought that first thing might be true, but we might be wrong. So we keep going.
So who's first in this?
Ronnie Arbo.
Ronnie! Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Hi, everybody. I'm going to sing a song that Pete wrote after he went to sing at the funeral of a friend named John T. McManus, who was a co-owner of a radical newspaper, someone he admired very much. And after he finished this eulogy, funeral, the singing, he regretted that he didn't have an appropriate song to sing, something he felt was appropriate for the occasion. And so after that, he wrote this beautiful short song, which I think is one of the most perfect little songs I've ever heard, and it's called "To My Old Brown Earth." So I'm gonna send it out to Pete, because it really kind of feels to me like it's for him. "To my old brown earth, and to my old blue sky, I now give these last few molecules of I. And you who say, and you who stand nearby, I do charge you not to cry. Guard well our human chain. Watch well you keep it strong. As long as sun will shine. This our home, keep pure and sweet and green, for now I'm yours, and you are.
All right, this is a song that you all know. So sing with us. This is a song that you all know. So sing with us. I believe in you. I told Narissa we should add a verse about a phone, because phones seem to be really important these days. And I don't mean like your smartphone. I mean your phone that can call your congressperson or senator. Because that seems to be actually having an effect. So we're not going to sing that because Narissa says that it's poetically awkward, and she's the songwriter. But sentimentally, we all know that might be the weapon of the 21st century.
If I had a
Call your congresswoman. Congresswomen and the senator women seem to be doing a very good job right now, by and large. And next we have Sawyer Fredericks, who's going to sing The House of the Rising Sun, which both Woody Guthrie and Pete Seeger recorded.
So I'm not much of a talker, so I'll just skip the music. This song comes from an old Baptist hymn called Lay the Lily Low. But during the Harlan County, Kentucky strikes in the 1930s,
A woman named Florence Reese wrote this song when she wrote the words that most people sing nowadays to commemorate the occasion in which the company goons came to her house to kill her husband. And he didn't come home. And she said, I tore a calendar off the wall and wrote the words to this song as they were leaving the house. Now come on, you good workers, a story I will tell of how the good old union has come in here to dwell. Now which side are you on, boys? Which side are you on? Which side are you on, boys? Which side are you on? My daddy was a miner. And I'm sticking with the union until the battle's won. Say, which side are you on, boys? Which side are you on? Which side are you on, boys? Which side are you on? Now are you in Harlan County, where the sheriff and his gang trying to organize? Which side are you on, boys? Which side are you on? Which side are you on, girls? Which side are you on? Tell me, workers, how can you stand? Tell me how you can. Lousy scab, or will you be a man? So which side are you on, boys? Which side are you on? Which side are you on, boys? Which side are you on?
Say which side
which side are you on? Which side are you on, boy? Which side are you on? Which side are you on, girl? Which side are you on?
Kirsten Maxwell is going to lead us in Where Have All the Flowers Gone.
This is one of the first songs I learned when I started playing guitar because something about it got to me. And I know you're all warmed up now, so I better hear you. I think my guitar is,
Where have all the flowers gone? Long time passing. Where have all the flowers gone? Long time ago. Graveyards gone, long time past.
event that has happened at the Falcon Ridge Folk Festival, which is that we have finished our songs with time to spare. And so now is when chaotic awesomeness transpires. The Gaslight Tinkers are going to lead us.
Yes, we are.
It's a call and response.
It is.
And the call is not the same as the response. But when you hear the call, I bet you're smart enough to know what the response is.
I'm sure you
I'll can. Be the guinea pig. I'll try.
So, to respond. Hey, I just want to say, back there we got Joe Fitzpatrick on the drums. Derek Sawyer on the bass. Audrey Knuth on the fiddle. I'm Peter Siegel, and people used to say Peter Siegel like Pete Seeger, and I say, well, not really, but now they just say Peter Siegel like NPR, but,
Not really.
We're both bald Jews in the same age category. Wish I had his job.
This is better. It's better for us that you have this job, Peter.
So it's the caller's fun. So I grew up around the Sloop Clearwater, and that's one of the reasons why I'm standing here right now is because of Pete singing around me all the time and all that stuff. And so he would say, sailing up, and you'd say,
sailing up.
You say, sailing down.
Sailing down.
And then it's the opposite. Up.
Down.
Down.
Up.
Up and down the river, sailing on to me. Stopping all along the way. Sailing up, up, sailing up the river, baby. Thank you.
It takes a village to remember the songs and lyrics.
They say, leaving home every day, leaving that wild and dusty way to the California line.
Across the desert and gold,
in the old dust bowl, they think we're going to the sugar bowl, but here is what they find. Now the police and the parliamentary say, you're number 14,000 born in the Bay.
Thank you.
Ever stop in this folk festival.
Okay. So we're gonna sing This Land Is Your Land, and we were gonna do a really tight version, and instead we're gonna do a gigantic sprawling version in the key of D. And we're gonna start with a chorus, and we're gonna do a chorus between every verse, and we are gonna do two choruses at the end. And we're going to do all six verses that Woody wrote. Now, we had the pleasure of doing a show this fall with Sarah Lee Guthrie and Johnny Orion. And I was doing a version of this with my local chorus. And we did the four-chord version of this song. And Sarah Lee took me aside before the show when we were dress rehearsing and said, no. My grandfather wrote it with three chords. We're going to play it with three chords. And I don't mess with Sarah Lee Guthrie. So just three chords in D, guys.
This land is your land.
Thank you. We are fruit and snack all day to Sunday.
Tomorrow, I'm on stage.